Enjoy the best IPTV free services, Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment Service for any device from any location at affordable prices. But you
don't need this is a word of wisdom for your soul. Short, sweet, quick, and potent. When a person shows you who they are the first time, beloved, believe them. Don't validate it. Don't try to convince yourself of anything else. Believe what they show you because that's who they are. Love you.
I hope you choose people that choose you. I hope you realize that the bare minimum isn't actually effort. I hope you realize that when it's actually real, you don't have to beg someone to stay in your life. I hope you also realize that you don't have to prove yourself worthy of someone's love. You have nothing to prove. The right people will choose you. I hope you realize that inconsistency is a sign that someone might not be that interested. I hope you take people's actions over their words, because people will show you how they feel about you. They can say whatever they want. Believe what they show you. I hope you don't settle. I hope you realize that just because they didn't see your value doesn't mean you're not valuable. I hope you realize that one day you will be loved the right way. And just because you haven't in the past doesn't mean it isn't out there. I hope you don't give up.
They're showing you who they are. They're not showing you who they can be. So why are you believing that? They're showing you who they are. For your sake, you should probably believe them.
My dear, when people show you who they are, why don't you believe them? Why must you be shown 29 times before you can see who they really are? Why can't you get it the first time? When people show you who they are, believe them the first time.
I'm at a place in my life now where I expect from people exactly what they show me. Like, if you show me who you are, that's exactly what I have to believe until you show me something different. I still have to be me. I still have to operate out of love. I still have to walk with integrity. So it's just like, believe what they show you, man. They showing you, it's revealed to you for a reason. Don't try to argue with whatever that reason is. Just accept that for what it is. Doesn't mean that they're a bad person. Sometimes it just means that they're not there yet. They don't understand or see it from your perspective or see it for the truth that it really is. Like, they just ain't there yet. And you have to be okay with that. I wouldn't even expect certain people to understand, child. I wouldn't. So I ain't even gonna put that expectation or that pressure on them. That ain't my job. God has an appointed time for them to wake up and smell the coffee, and it might not be right now. They probably got to go through one more test, one more thing. You never know. Like, I don't want to play around with God's timing. I don't want to play around with God's will. Like, that's their life. Let them live it. Like, I'm never going to beat nobody up about anything that I grew to understand, because I had to grow to understand it, child. I didn't understand it in the beginning either. You know, I didn't see myself being where I'm at with this type of wisdom, this type of understanding and knowledge right now. Back a couple months ago, I ain't have it. You know, that was my reality too. So I ain't gonna judge you. I ain't gonna put no pressure on you. But I will be moving in where I'm supposed to be going.
And thank you.
Yo, folk like to make it like you off on something. Stop talking to them. We gotta stop talking to folk about their actions, their motives, and who we seeing them to truly be. It reminded me the other day, like Maya Angelou said, when people show you who they are, you better believe them. We get to talking to them about it because we're trying to rationalize with devils. No, believe what they are. Believe what they're showing you.
Six things I wish I knew earlier.
Number one, life won't be easy. And that's the point. Number two, believe people when they show you who they are the first time, including yourself. Number three, love is not a feeling. It's a decision. Every time. Number four, forgiveness isn't always easy. It's a choice, and one that we must sometimes make over and over and over again. Number five, your greatest strengths will somehow be inexplicably entwined with your greatest weaknesses. And number six, you're going to make a lot of mistakes in life, but if you learn to see your mistakes correctly and leverage them, your mistakes will become the keys to the future you crave.
I did a video about potential. There's a lot of people that know game and know how to talk a good game to get a date, be it man or woman, and they sell a bag of crap, and people buy it. And then when they wonder when they get it. But if somebody tells you who they are, believe it. That's what Maya Angelou said. I never understood the song that R. Kelly, pardon me saying that, made for Miss Hudson Lady. When she was standing out in the winter cold waiting on a man and he never showed. You said you're going to get a job, go to church. What you doing with him? He don't have a job. And you like church men. I don't get it. I wrote a counter song to that. I didn't understand. I ain't standing out in the cold waiting for you. As soon as I get out there and it's snowing, you ain't out there waiting for me, I'm out. I'm still like that today. I'm not waiting on no foolishness. So get potential if you want to, but don't complain when all you see is the potential.
Listen, when it comes to dating, if somebody isn't willing to put in the effort, you do not need to make that your problem. They're saying to you, look, I'm not willing to take care of myself, show up for myself, and therefore I'm not putting in any effort for you. I don't know how to do that because I'm not even doing that in my own life. Come on, are you with me?
Okay, so this video is actually about an Amber Heard video, which I will play in a second. But firstly, can we say this filter? This filter was made for women of color. I'm sorry, you will not convince me otherwise. Anyway, on to my point. So I want to play a video by Amber in the corner of the day where she's being cross-examined regarding the audio tape that we've all heard where she calls Johnny a big baby. On this audio clip, I figured out that she was a narcissist from this audio clip, and specifically from when she was being cross-examined by it, because of how she reacted to it. They'll play the clip, then she'll respond. And when you watch it, I want to remember this, that a narcissist will always tell you something despite it not corroborating with what you've seen. So if they tell you something like, no, I would never hit you, I'm not that kind of person, I'm not a violent person, and you turn around and go, you hit me the other day. No, that's not what happened. Very narcissist thing to say, because despite the fact that you know it happened, they think that their word, because of who they are, because they are so important and are so the main character, that their word should trump everything, even when presented with the opposite. So just bear that in mind, that the evidence does not corroborate with what she's saying, but she will adamantly tell you the situation. And the phrase, when someone shows you who they are, believe them, should always be applied to a narcissist. Never believe what they say, always believe what they show you.
Like this, but I did not punch you. I did not.
And next thing you know, my accountant died, and a girl that worked for him called my lawyer and said, we have a problem. She had found on the floor all my tax forms for 7 years signed and with the checks stapled to them. So I'm thinking, I'd have signed and I'd have stapled the checks. Well, they were cashing the checks, keeping the money, and not turning in the tax form.
So yeah, that's where we interviewed Fat Joe. Similar situation. He went to jail for that, actually, tax evasion. So your accountant, you were signing the check. Oh, so you didn't know who the check was being made out to?
Oh, to the government.
So how did they cash it?
Well, they didn't cash it. They took the money out of the account that matched the exact, because I wasn't watching it.
So like, you could just see 100,000,
100,000, 600,000, deducted.
Yeah, you're looking at
deducted. So I'm thinking it's the check. Little did I know, it was some people taking the money out.
For 7 years?
For 7 years.
How much money did that?
I ended up owing $22
million. Wow.
$22 million with the penalties. So now, listen to me, man. Me and my wife in 2008, I get the call. And the way I found out was, my lawyer called me and said, hey man, we got a problem. You haven't paid taxes in 7 years.
Hey, hello. Goldberg's shocking moments and comments came as The View hosts were discussing a Tennessee school board's decision to remove a novel about the Holocaust from its curriculum. Was this a racist move? Was the question. That was the topic. Well, no, according to Whoopi Goldberg. And then, oh, the cringeworthy explanation why.
Let's be truthful about it, because the Holocaust isn't about race. It's about man's inhumanity to man.
Okay, here's really where it gets cringy. Her co-hosts were then calling her out, but the comments still created an international uproar, you know, outside the studio where they live. So Whoopi tried to clean things up on The Late Show with Stephen Colbert. Girls got friends. Watch.
I feel being black, when we talk about race, it's a very different thing to me. Mm-hmm. So I said that I felt that the Holocaust wasn't about race. Mm-hmm. This wasn't based on the skin. You couldn't tell who was Jewish. Mm-hmm. They had to delve deeply to figure it out. If the Klan is coming down the street, mm-hmm. and I'm standing with a Jewish friend and neither one, well, I'm gonna run. But if my friend decides not to run, they'll get passed by most times because you can't tell who's Jewish.
Oh my gosh.
Just last hour, she tried to clean it up again on The View.
It is indeed about race, because Hitler and the Nazis considered Jews to be an inferior race. The words matter, and mine are no exception. I regret my comments, as I said, and I stand corrected. I also stand with the Jewish people, as they know, and y'all know, because I've always done that.
Because you have a Jewish
name. And KKK is nearby, in which case you will leave them on the curb. Trey.
What a mess.
You know, I have a couple of pretty simple rules in life. Paris, don't ever compare anything to slavery. Don't ever compare anything to the Holocaust. And if you're a man, don't compare anything to pregnancy. That's rule number one. Rule number two, if you're going to apologize, then just apologize. Don't explain it. Don't try to mitigate it. Apologize and ask for forgiveness. And number three, as a culture, we have got to do a better job of figuring out who is just famous and who actually knows what he or she is talking about, because sometimes we confuse the two.
Wow.
Sometimes you gotta allow people to be who they are instead of trying to change them for who you want them to be. See, a lot of times when we get into relationships and we start to choose friends, we choose them based off of potential, based off of the future, not based off of who they are now. And years later, when things start to brew and all hell breaks loose, because those individuals are not changing as fast as you expected them to change, or they haven't changed at all, now you're stuck, because now your emotions are involved, your feelings are involved, and now you can't get away, or it's very hard for you to break off, because you did not believe them when they showed you who they were in the very beginning. Understand this, you can't change people that are not willing to change. You gotta stop expecting more for others that don't expect more for themselves. We got planes to catch. We ain't got time for the nonsense.
Here are five things you need to remember. Number one, remember, when somebody shows you who they are, believe them. Number two, remember, can't nobody break your heart more than once without your permission. Number three, remember, everybody ain't gonna have a heart like you, so stop expecting you from them. Number four, remember, the more chances you give to them, the less respect they'll start to have for you. Number five, remember, you'll never heal your life by staying in the pain that's destroying your life. Straight up.
When someone shows you who they are, believe them. If they do something shady or untrustworthy, that's who they are. And you know, I believe people can change. I've met people who have done really bad things who I've seen turn into, you know, lovely people. But change is obvious. You know, the remorse and the process of change is when you see that happen in someone, everyone around them knows they've really changed. But if someone does something shady to you and you don't see that process of change, don't just assume in your head that they've changed because they said they have. You know, assume that they're gonna be that same person that they were before, unless some drastic shift has very obviously happened with them. And it doesn't mean you have to cut them off, but just, you know, keep it in the back of your mind. If someone was once a snake, they're almost certainly gonna be a snake again, unless, you know, it, as I say, the change is very obvious. So I hope that's useful in some way.
Stories about I was waiting and I couldn't believe it and he didn't call me and I don't know what happened. She was saying, my dear, in her Maya voice, my dear, when people show you who they are, why don't you believe them? Why must you be shown 29 times before you can see who they really are? Why can't you get it the first time? So the adjunct to that is, when people show you who they are, believe them the first time. Don't wait for the 29th time.
Have you ever sat and thought about something a friend did to you in the past? And you be like, Damn, why did I stay this person friend?